Hop in the whip and I hit these switches. See that chrome suspension. Look at the car, you know who did it.
What's up and good morning, guys. How are you? Alex here from Hoppo with another video for you guys. And today we're starting off the video kind of in a rush because what this video is about is actually already here. We just kind of did something, and there might be a new toy showing up right now. Not sure. I saw a big rig show up back through the cameras. Vic over there unloading. Let's go take a look at what it is. This machine is roughly about 4x8, and it has a lot of capabilities that we don't have, which is very needed around here because production is it's a little overwhelming for our small crew that we have. So we're trying to step things up a bit. And to make things a little easier here, we're just gonna do a little testing to see how things are gonna work out for us. Are pretty much almost all set up here. We got a few little things we got to finish up, but they got everything leveled out. They got everything set up. They got everything wired in. We got internet over here that we were doing a few days ago. We got power already here. And now, look at, this is exciting. Ready? Oh my God, look at that thing. That is so freaking cool. I've always seen these guys online. I've always wanted them. We've seen a few of these when we went to some of the machine expos. And this thing is freaking bad. Bad. And we haven't even got to run it yet. But we go into training in about the next 30 minutes. Right now they went to go take a lunch break. We got the tablet here. We got all of the buttons and functions. And they say it's pretty simple, but I'll be the judge of that. But I'm excited, super excited. This is just gonna step our production up just that bit more. Actually, it's gonna be stepping up a lot more because we'll be able to cut on the laser, do the bending that we gotta do, and at the same time, the robot will be welding, or technically the cobot will be welding, and we could get everything all going all at the same time with least amount of hands on it, because we just gotta set it up, click the button, let it weld, let it do its thing, take it off, move to the next one. So this is a very exciting, a huge step for us. This is just a big trial run for us, really, to see how we're gonna adapt into this whole world, because we all know robots, cobots, automation is the next level of manufacturing, and for us this is our next step into something very cool. We're gonna go ahead and jump straight into pretty much training. So we're gonna have training for the rest of the day today, and then tomorrow we're gonna have partial training plus start the first arc, and that's when things get fun, because then we get to play with it and we get out weld up a whole bunch of things using this freaking super sick robot. All right, guys, so we finally got everything going. It is all set up. We are actually running 12-inch cylinders right now as we speak. Again, this is a very big and exciting moment for us because this just really ramps up our production. We're literally able to produce these in a fraction of the time. Imagine welding all these by hand. Very enthusiastic, as you can tell. All right, go ahead, baby, push the button. just like that, in under 12 seconds, we got 1/12-inch cylinder done. So it's a matter of how quick can you replenish the machine, the robot, the cobot. This thing is going to be a game changer for us. So, all right, load it up. Let's keep it running. So by the end of the day today, we should have, actually the next, let's just, I'm going to give it like 30 seconds per piece, just because right now we're playing with it and enjoying it. But if we're in full production mode, we could actually get about 300 sets of cylinders done in under an hour. So very impressive. Now, I don't think we're ever going to need that much, because that's a lot of cylinders in a 10, 12 hour day. So, but it definitely has the capability of doing that. And that's literally on a single fixture, single cobot. It's pretty insane on what these things can do. Go ahead, Rick. We actually ended up doing a little over 200 pieces yesterday on our first day of running this thing, and it's been an absolute freaking game changer.